This video brought to you by TCI Products, Dual Sport Adventure Accessories. Hey guys, Northwest Adventure Rider here. So this is going to be a quick video showing you what the Givi crash bars or engine guards look like on my DL650. First, you may have noticed that I'm wearing glasses. I finally got in to get an eye exam done, a diabetic eye exam. And my eye health is really good. However, the initial high blood sugar episodes that caused me to wear glasses, you know, back in January, it did take its toll, and I am farsighted now. So I need to wear glasses, you know, for doing things that are probably my vision within about 5 or 10 feet or so, especially if I'm in front of the computer or reading or something like that. But anyway, let's get to the bike. So here it is, my 05 DL650 V-Strom K5, the Givi crash bars. And it's actually pronounced Givi. I don't know why I keep calling it Givi. But this is the newer style. I guess they had two different styles. Both styles, they mount here. But the older styles, not only did they mount here, but it was welded to this plate, and the new ones, it's bolted to this plate. I guess that they were having issues with this plate breaking. So mine's a newer one. It does have this block right here, and I thought that it was some kind of an anti-vibration block, but it's not. It's just a piece of plastic that clamps to it. I think it's just for their namesake. So I did end up doing spark plugs on the bike. I put the NGK iridium spark plugs in there, completely drained the fuel tank because it had that bad fuel in it, and it runs great now. So I put about 150 miles on it in the last couple of days, and she runs like a top. So anyway, that's the way it is. Still absolutely love the rack system on there. The ammo cans, you know, I'm starting to like them more and more. You know, the biggest thing is that I like the fact that they're very inexpensive. So, and they do hold lots of stuff. And on this bike, it really isn't that much weight. It's less weight than if you had a passenger on there. And they are symmetrical, so you can see that there's this big space here where you can add some kind of a tool tube or something, which I intend on doing. So anyway, can't say enough about this. TCI Products, Outback Rack. They make several different rack systems for this same bike and all the different kinds of bikes. Head over to their website, check them out. But yeah, that's that. One thing that I couldn't find a real good picture of when I was looking at these crash bars was just exactly how much it stuck off from the sides. So I don't know if you can see that here, but they do stay off from the sides. I don't know, 2.5 to 3 inches or so. So, you know, they're not right tight against the plastic. They're definitely narrower than the handlebars, but they do stand off a little bit. Very, very simple to install. Only took me about, 20 minutes to do it, and that's because I was taking my time with it. The only thing that you have to disassemble on the bike is removing this piece of plastic, which is this one screw here. Pop that off on both sides. Then you remove the motor mount bolts. First, you want to remove these motor mount bolts. Lightly or loosely attach the plate to the bar. Put these bolts in, and then remove these motor mount bolts here, and then put those back in with the new bolts. I'm torn though. Riding the bike with my helmet anyway, I get lots of turbulence on the top of my helmet. Now, I started out with the windscreen adjusted all the way down, and it was horrible. Now it's adjusted all the way up and is better, but still not good. So I'm torn between getting a touring windshield next or a radiator guard. Now, this bike isn't one that I'm going to be taking off-road or anything, just back roads or fire roads, logging roads, whatever you want to call them. In fact, I already have done a little bit. You can see some of the dust build up on my wheels down there. But So, I mean, they're going to be about the same price. Radiator guard, touring windscreen. The windscreen is more for comfort. Radiator guard is obviously to prevent from damage. So what do you guys think? Which one should I get? Windscreen, radiator guard? Leave your opinion in the comments section below. Well, I guess that's about it for now. Don't forget to rate, comment, subscribe.